A politician pushes Azerbaijani propaganda, and the world changes on November 3rd. What do Rachel Maddow's ratings have to say about what comes next? All right, everyone. I got a lot to say, but first, you need to subscribe to this channel, and you need to share this video, and click the notification bell if you want to be notified when I put up new videos. All right, first thing I want to do is speak to all of you. I have a lot of Azerbaijanis and Turks and Armenians and Christians who watch this show, and you may ask, why should you listen to what I have to say? There's so much information out there. I get accused in the comment section of just of spouting and believing Armenian propaganda. Now, I want you to look at this. This is just a segment from one of the videos I put up here a long time ago, and that trophy right there. Now, I'm not showing you that trophy out of pride and arrogance. It's mine. It has my name on it. I've worked in television for 15 years, and for 10 years, I was a reality TV editor, and for 5 years, I was an entertainment news editor. So what does that mean? Reality TV, everybody says it's fake. Yeah, it's fake. So I'm an expert at detecting BS, right? I know how to manipulate video and sound bites to get you to believe anything. And then is this trophy I won for entertainment news. And what does that mean? I recognize spin. I know how to spin. The best way to recognize spin is to know how to spin. So when it comes to information and what propaganda is, I have a little bit of credibility. That's all I have to say. All right, let's listen.
I can assure you that Joe Biden, when he gets elected, some of us who are part of the Democratic Party will keep doing our work to make sure that Joe Biden has a policy that is fair and that is an interest of all the parties. In this case, Azerbaijan is the target of aggression, and that must be noted.
All right. He said some good things. He and the Democratic Party are going to push for, I think he said, justice, something like that. And that's, you know, that's a good political line to take. But at the end, he said, Azerbaijan, see if I can cue that up.
In this case, Azerbaijan is the target of aggression.
Azerbaijan is the target of aggression. That's it. That is propaganda. If you know anything about what's going on, Nagorno-Karabakh has been sitting there with Armenians living happily forever. And then the bombs started falling. They're the targets of aggression. And there's a tactic used in propaganda. It's when you might call it projection or cover. And it happens in propaganda where the other side, the enemy accuses you of exactly what they're doing. And you just heard it. This is a politician running for office and repeating Azerbaijani propaganda. Now, what does Rachel Maddow have to do with any of this? Well, November 3rd, maybe you're watching this after the election. Maybe you're watching it right before the election. The world's going to change one way or the other. And if Biden wins, as we just heard from this politician, he and the Democratic Party or his cohorts are going to push for Nagorno-Karabakh to be recognized as Azerbaijani territory. If Donald Trump wins, here may be a picture of exactly what happens. If you don't know who Rachel Maddow is, she's an opinion talking head on MSNBC. And she's essentially staked her career on peddling the Trump is a Putin puppet line, right? It's just been her stock and trade. She spends her episodes talking about Russia conspiracy and any evidence or even any, you know, every angle of that conspiracy. That's, you know, that's her fodder, like her, that's her audience. And some people only watch her. Some people watch a lot of different news sources. But here is an article from May 29th, 2019. Rachel Maddow just had her lowest rated month of the Trump presidency. May has not been Rachel Maddow's month. What? Why is that? I'm not going to read this article. It's just, this is just a ratings article. What happened in April, just before May? At the end of April of 2019 was the release of the Mueller report. Up until the release of the Mueller report, and the Mueller report, if you don't know, was a two-year, the result of a two-year investigation into Russia conspiracy that Donald Trump had been compromised or in bed with the Russians to steal the 2016 election. And the two-year investigation headed by Republican Robert Mueller and then a staff of like 15 lawyers and Weissman, I think was his, most people are saying that Weissman was actually running the show. If you saw the interview with Robert Mueller, it looked like he had, he was past his prime, not exactly in top form. And so most people consider that that investigation was run by all the other lawyers. But what happened when that report was released is it probably the most important result or statement. There's a lot of, you know, bad stuff in there about Trump. Sure, he's a creep. He's a bully. He's, you know, bull in a china shop, you might say. But it said, as a result of the two-year investigation, no American was tied to Russian interference or conspiring with Russians. No American, not just not Trump and not just not anybody associated with him or his campaign, but no American. There's a two-year, $40 million investigation staffed with anti-Trump lawyers. I mean, I'm not going to say they were all anti-Trump. Maybe they were, but there were certainly anti-Trump lawyers on staff, like this guy, Weissman guy. I think he was at Hillary's victory celebration on election night thinking, you know, like she was going to win and he was there. So, I mean, that's not an unbiased lawyer. That's a person that would jump on any dirt on Trump. So when the Mueller report comes out and determines that it was all there, there was no Russia collusion, right? There was none. It was the result of the Mueller report, the investigation of, you know, a bunch of hired guns to go after the president. I mean, that's, I'm trying to be fair here, but that's what happened. And Rachel Maddow had been peddling that Russia, that Trump was in bed with Russia, that Putin was, you know, pulling the strings. And then when our own extensive investigation result in nothing, she had been promising and promising and promising her viewers this bad stuff, that this is the proof. You know, they were selling t-shirts. They were, I mean, literally they were selling paraphernalia about how what the savior that Russia, that the Mueller was. This episode is getting way too long already, but her ratings tanked. She was peddling Putin propaganda. I mean, essentially she was a Putin puppet by repeating what turned out to be propaganda fed to the DNC by a Russian agent or a potential Russian agent. I won't go into that detail, but Rachel Maddow's ratings tanked. And I'll read this. MSNBC host, and this is a month later after May, MSNBC host Rachel Maddow's ratings slide continues despite unprecedented news cycle. And this article talks about her highest rated month ever. Where is it? Let me just read this. Rachel Maddow's success was a one-trick pony. That trick was Trump-Russia conspiracy theories on an Alex Jones level of crazy. After the Mueller report, Maddow's decline was inevitable. Cornell Law School professor and media critic William A. Jacobson told Fox News, referencing the findings from former special counsel Robert Mueller. She got a respite due to impeachment hysteria, but now that too has passed, there's no reason for anyone except the hardcore left to watch her. Jacob adds, added her. her decline could be permanent unless some other political paranoid delusions draw people back to her. Maddow's highest rated month ever was January 2019 at the height of her nightly what ifs regarding whether or not President Trump's administration colluded with Russia. Maddow even, okay. So 4 months earlier, she had her highest rated month ever, January. And then February, March, April, May. 5 months later, she has her worst rated month because she pushed this false story. November 3rd is, it could be one of these seminal moments where not just Rachel Maddow, I'm just picking out her as an example, but you've got the mainstream media, MSM as it was referred to, you've got, you know, all the big channels and anchors and news heads, and even your local stations, talking about Biden's ratings. Biden's ahead in the polls, and all the polls say that Biden's going to win, even though they're tightening a little bit. And so you've got people that are believing that Joe Biden is going to be the next president of the United States. On June 3rd or 4th, or whenever all the lawsuits settle down, if Trump wins, this is going to be a repeat, but at a greater scale, because things have gotten more heightened since this happened. And so our world is going to change one way or the other. If Biden wins the presidency, his administration looks like it's going to make some fundamental changes to our constitutional structure, potentially expanding the Supreme Court, voting to make Washington, D.C. a state and Puerto Rico a state, adding senators to the Senate, and, you know, some radical transformations to our culture. So if Joe Biden wins, our world is going to change dramatically. And if Trump wins, our world is going to change dramatically because of the media. Let me show you one more thing to tie this back to Azerbaijan. This is the World Press Freedom Index. And so what this is, let me just summarize it for you. The colors here represent the freedom of the press, or how reliable press is in different parts of the world. The lighter colors are at the top, the most reliable sources. Like, you can believe a lot of the news coming out the lighter the color is. So this pale yellow and orange are all pretty good. It ranks all the countries 1 through 180. You see North Korea is number 180. That is a communist dictatorship that is completely shut down. So black and red are really bad. Anybody in black and red is toward the bottom of this scale here. And it's just based on access to reporters, access to people reporting the news on the ground. If you zoom in, let me navigate here, zoom in a little bit more to our locale. Right here is Armenia, 61. So toward the top out of 180 countries. And then right next to it, oops, zoom, come on, is Azerbaijan. Get ready for this. Armenia is fairly open news source, reliable news source. Lots of journalists in there reporting what's going on. 168 out of 180. They are at the bottom. You cannot trust the news coming out of Azerbaijan. Look at this over here. Look at the bottom. Who's at the bottom? North Korea. China is the fourth from the bottom. And Azerbaijan, 168. So I just want to wrap this up. I'm a newsman. I'm an independent journalist, a former television post-production editor and producer. I know how to manipulate media. I know how to recognize faked media. I know how reality can be manipulated. That's my profession. That's what I've done for 15 years. So I'm just trying to give you evidence. You Turks and Azerbaijanis who may watch this, You propaganda is believing lies. And there's an expression, the truth will set you free. Well, what's the inverse? A lie will make you a slave. If you believe propaganda, you have become enslaved to someone else's lie. They're manipulating you. Armenia did not attack Azerbaijan. They may have dropped a bomb in Ganja. In the next episode, I'm gonna read an article, actually the Armenian president talking about that. He's asked point blank, why did Armenia bomb Ganja? And he pretty much supported one of the suppositions I made in another video, that there are military targets, and some people put military targets in civilian neighborhoods. And so if some of this, the repercussions are those neighborhood buildings are affected, that is like if you are committing a felony and you kill somebody in the act of a felony, or somebody dies, say the police shoot somebody trying to stop you from committing a felony, you are responsible for that murder because you are the felon. That's the law. If you're committing a felony and the police have to use lethal force to stop you and an innocent bystander dies in the line of them doing their duty, you, the felon, are responsible for that murder. And that's what happened in Ganja. All right, I'm going to wrap this up here. So like, subscribe, and share.